Not quite. Nope. Really striking out on pitchwood today. Sometimes it's in these roots, sometimes it's not. A lot of times it'll be the last thing that's not rotten. Ooh, what's this? Oh, there we go. See that color? That's what we're looking for, that color. Not as much as I'm hoping for, but... very awkward spot to do this. It's not good fire starting material, but it's definitely good firewood. Not much resin in there, but it, well, it was until I rolled it in the snow. It's fairly dry though, so we can use this in our fire. Speaking of fire, I think this camera's about dead. Let's go get a fire going. Good fire material right there. very wet. Everything's wet, 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 wet. Perfect size for that little stove. Even dry wood's damp. Just enough for flavor. It's actually quite good. If you've ever had rose hipped, you know. If you haven't, they taste something like, yeah, let's see if I can get some decent lighting. Wow, this camera always seems to be overexposed. If you've never had rose hip, it's kind of a cross between a tomato and an apple. It has the flavor of an apple, but the more mellow sweetness of a tomato. It's pretty good. Makes a good tea, a good trail snack. You can dry them. You can do all kinds of things with them. And the nice thing is they stay on the plant for, they can stay pretty much all year, depending on moisture, you know, the exposure to sunlight, that sort of thing. So something to look out for. We have lots of them out here. All right, this battery's about gone. So I think I'm gonna pack up, finish my little trail tea here, and head back in. See ya.